Yeah, well, I don't think your mum's going to be giving you such a hard time anymore. So maybe, finally, we can be a couple.
You are to be incarcerated for a period of 9 years, with a non-parole period of 5 years and 10 months.
Morning, sweet lips.
Don't ever call me that again.
Yeah, you've been avoiding me.
Well, you've noticed. I'm impressed.
Well, it's hard not to. I mean, 3 days without any phone calls or text messages.
That kiss was a complete mistake. I don't know how
you were totally into it. Couldn't get enough.
I did actually get enough. It won't be happening again.
Right. Okay.
How's your dad?
Yeah, he's fine. Thanks for asking.
I have tables to clean. Letting me win on purpose?
No. I promise I'm not. I just can't help it if you're so distracting.
My shot. What?
Nothing, I'm just enjoying this. Being able to hang with you without your mum worrying about it. And I was kind of wondering if you wanted to come to mine for dinner tonight. Don't let him get to you.
Can you believe he only got 100 hours community service for what he did?
I didn't even know he'd been sentenced. Why didn't you say anything?
I don't really like talking about it. I'm trying to forget, but seeing him around makes it impossible.
We'll just get out of here. We'll go to the beach or something.
No, I'm meeting Mum for lunch. Actually, I might just go and wait for her now. But I'll see you later.
Okay, well, dinner and wine, yes, no, maybe. Come on, I'm going to cook something really good, please.
Yeah, okay, I'll call you.
The right thing here, Irene. A clean break. It's the best way.
Look, I can see where you're coming from, but this is not a decision you can make on your own.
Well, I've got to. Kirsty will just try and talk me out of it. I know she thinks she can cope with it now, but in a couple of years,
oh,
she's just
going to... come off it. Kirsty's tough. You know that. For God's sake, she stuck with you all those years on the run, didn't she? When she sets her mind to something, she follows through.
Face it, Irene. You heard what they said in court? I come from a pretty screwed up family. I'm just one of them.
Oh, stop talking like that.
No, even if I'm lucky and I get out in 5 years, then what have I got to offer? I've got a criminal record. I've got no skills. I've never even had a regular job. My wife and my kid deserve a lot better than that.
You know what? You might be right. The fact remains, they've got you, mate. You are part of their lives, and that is never going to change.
I don't want my son to visit me behind bars. I mean, what's it going to be like when he goes to school and the kids ask, hey, what does your daddy do? Kirsty loves the Bay. It's where she wants to live. I'm going to be transferred out of here tomorrow to I don't know where, and I don't want her living in some hole just to be close to me. I want Ollie to grow up near the beach, around people that love him. Just like you.
Kane, you have to see Kirsty and talk to her, even if it's just to tell her what you just told me. Love you, owe her that much.
Are you stalking me now?
Oh, we didn't get a chance to finish our little chat before.
Yes, we did. What do you think you're doing?
Well, I thought you might have wanted another photo op. Where's your camera?
The photo jokes are getting a little old, don't you think?
I'll tell you what's getting old. You pretending you don't want me.
Will you get over yourself?
I will. As soon as you stop playing hard to get, come for a swim with me. Look, I promise to play nice.
You don't know the meaning of nice.
All right. Okay, I am sorry for acting like a tool this morning. All right, the whole sweet lips thing wasn't exactly my best material, I will admit. But come on, quick dip. On your lunch break, let's go.
chicken medallions in mushroom sauce. Which part of the chicken is a medallion?
What about this minted ratatouille thing?
Ratatouille, doll. Kirsty, I'm home, love.
Hey, Irene, thanks for letting me invite Melody for dinner. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome. But if I were you, I'd be doing something a bit simpler, you know, like a roast or something.
Irene, did you get through to him?
He's agreed to see you, love.
Thank you so much. I knew that he'd listen to you.
Love, you need to know that he's really down at the moment and he's really intent on doing things in his own way.
It doesn't matter. If he's agreed to see me, I can get through to him.
You do know that he's been transferred to another jail tomorrow, don't you?
Yeah, Morag said that might happen, but honestly, it doesn't matter. Ollie and I can move nearby. It's fine.
Love, look, I really need to get to this meeting at the diner, but please do me a favour. Wait until you've spoken to Kane before you make any plans.
Irene, we're a family. Where he goes, I go. Looking for your dad, he's in a meeting with Leah. You and Aiden looked pretty cosy on the beach before.
He was spying on us.
I was just walking fast. I was on my lunch break. We went for a swim. So to you. He said he was going to go visit his dad at the hospital, but instead he was wasting time with you.
Whether Aiden sees his dad or not has nothing to do with me.
Right, so I mean you don't even care that the guy hasn't visited
him. What is your problem?
Just forget it.
The truth is, financially, the den isn't doing well. You both know I've been behind with my share of the utility bills.
Yeah, but that's nothing to worry about.
It is when I've got no idea how I'm going to pay it back. I'm not kidding. It's at that point.
Love, why didn't you say something? Of course we'll help you out.
Yeah, if it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be in business in the first place.
Guys, I'm not telling you this so I can get money off you. Basically, the den isn't working. It's a money pit and I've got no more to put in. And that's why I've decided to close it down. Permanently.
You can't just make that decision for us, Kane. Whatever happened to in good times and in bad?
What good times, Kirst? We've been on the run. We're going to give away our little boy.
But we don't have to do that now.
You, Irene, Alf, you all could have ended up inside because of me. I mean, honestly, is that the kind of guy you want to hang out for? Just while you're raising our son single-handedly? I mightn't have told you about the robberies, but I still did them. I still put that security guard in hospital. And I can't bear to think of you waiting around while I sit in here. It's not fair.
Why are you talking to me like this?
So what? You to forget about me. I want you to take Ollie and start a new life without me.
Time's up, Phillips.
Kane, I love you.
I love you too.
Full of steam, it could take no vacant dream.
To I was meant to be a legacy, a living memory of him, something positive to come out of his death, and instead.
I think it was all of those things, Leah. You haven't failed. Okay, so teenagers don't have a lot of cash to throw around. They still love the place.
We all do. Oh, love, Dan would be so proud of you and what you've done with this place. So don't you dare go thinking of it as a failure. Oh, sweetheart, it's going to be okay. You'll be all right. Don't know what.